My brother Josh just passed away recently from diabetes complications he struggled with all his life, really. So I'm dedicating this song to him and hoping that you guys will come join me.
Amazing grace, how sweet the sound that saved a wretch like me. Lost, but now I'm found, was blind, but now I see. 'Twas grace that taught my heart to fear, and grace my fears relieved. How precious that grace appeared, the eye I first believed. My chains are gone, I've been set free. My God, my Savior, has ransomed me, and like a
Well, praise the Lord. This is Elder Susan Kaur welcoming you all to the church service tonight. They're coming up on the Thanksgiving season, so I'm excited again. It's been a couple years since I've ministered, but I constantly minister before the Lord and keep myself prepared for the enemy's attacks. Thank God for each and every one of you. We miss you. I want to give honor to Pastor Barbara Matthews and Assistant Pastor Lorenza Johnson, all of the elders and ministers, and the congregation, our brothers and sisters in Christ. I want to take our prayer request at this time. So please start entering your prayer request in the chat box. And if I don't call everyone's name, I want you to also know that God sees those requests. He's heard those requests, and He is answering before we make our petition known unto Him. So at this time, join with me in prayer. Dear Heavenly Father, Lord, we come to You in the name of Jesus Christ, presenting each and every one of these prayer requests unto You. We pray for Rhonda Miller, Lord God, and Father, we ask You for a miracle in her body. We pray for Brother Frank Carter and the Carter family. We ask You, Lord God, for Your will to be done and for Your love and Your strength and Your comfort at this time. Lord God, we also pray for those that are sick and shut in of our friends and our congregation and family members, Lord God. Those that are lost, we ask You to save them. Those that need deliverance, we, Lord God, decree and declare their deliverance is on the way. Father God, we thank You for Your love and care, Your kindness, Your healing power, Your comforting power, Your keeping power. We praise God right now that those whose minds is stayed on You, You give us perfect peace. There's peace to our minds, peace to our souls, Lord God. Healing is the children's bread. And You said where any two agree in anything that we ask the Father in the name of Jesus Christ, that it shall be done. We ask You, Lord God, that our loved ones be saved, healed, delivered. Those, God, that need jobs, create those jobs. Lord God, the right job. Hallelujah. The right hours, the right pay, the right type of work, Lord God. We pray right now, God, that the virus will be captive and cast out and sent back to the pits from whence it came, bound for eternity, never again to be released on this earth to cause sickness, disease, and death. Lord God, we thank You right now, God, that those that have died in the Lord will rejoice knowing that they are forever with the Lord. And Lord God, hide me behind the cross as I bring forth Your word tonight. I pray, Lord Jesus, that You will anoint my lips to deliver the word that You have spoken unto me. Anoint the ears of the hearer and the heart to receive. And Lord God, we'll be careful to give You all the praise, all the glory, and all the honor. We pray for our leadership. We pray for the body of Christ. We pray for our government and our nation, our local government, as well as our federal government. And Lord God, all authority is in Your hand, and You are in control. In Jesus' name, amen. And praise God. We thank God for each and every one of you for being with us tonight. And we thank God for His love. We thank God that He is in control. We thank God for all that He is doing and going to do in the rest of this year. We thank God for His keeping power. We thank God most of all for his health and his strength and the comfort of the sweet Holy Ghost and the love between the brothers and the sisters. I want to go tonight to Psalms 100. Make a joyful noise unto the Lord, all ye lands. Serve the Lord with gladness. Come before his presence with singing. Know ye that the Lord, he is God. It is he that has made us and not we ourselves. We are his people and the sheep of his pasture. Enter into his gates with thanksgiving and into his courts with praise. Be thankful unto him and bless his name. For the Lord is good. His mercy is everlasting, and his truth endureth to all generations. I was reading in a commentary that Psalms 100 was considered a song that the Jews always and the Israelites always sang before they gave thanks to the Lord in their meals, in their offerings, and in the gathering together. It was a psalm that they always sang together in thanksgiving. I also want to go over to the book of Psalms chapter 107. I'm going to skip around in this one. But the very first verse says, "Oh, give thanks unto the Lord, for he is good, for his mercy endureth forever. Let the redeemed of the Lord say so, whom he hath redeemed from the hand of the enemy, and gathered them out of the lands from the east and from the west, from the north and from the south." And let's skip on down to the 13th verse. "Then they cried unto the Lord in their trouble, and he saved them out of their distresses. He brought them out of darkness and the shadow of death, and brake their bands in sunder. Oh, that men would praise the Lord for his goodness and for his wonderful works to the children of men. For he hath broken the gates of brass and cut the bars of iron in sunder. Fools, because of their transgression and because of their iniquities, are afflicted. Their soul abhors all manner of meat, and they draw near unto the gates of death. Then they cry to the Lord in their trouble, and he saved them out of their distresses." This right here is an example that even the wicked, when they cried out to the Lord in their distress, it says he saved them out of their distresses. In the 20th verse, he says he sent his word and healed them and delivered them out of their destructions. 21st verse again says, "Oh, that men would praise the Lord for his goodness and for his wonderful works to the children of men. And let them sacrifice with sacrifices of thanksgiving and declare his works with rejoicing." Can you do that today? Can you stop thinking about what you left your job today, driving to and from work, to and from school, to and from your errands that you drove today? Can you forget about all of that? And can you offer unto the Lord, who is worthy to be praised, who is worthy to be lifted up, who is worthy to be glorified, and sacrifices of thanksgiving, and declare his works with rejoicing? Can you rejoice in knowing that your name is written down in the Lamb's Book of Life? Can you rejoice over a loving God who sent his only begotten Son unto the world, that whosoever would believe would not perish, but have everlasting life because of his ultimate sacrifice that he gave for us? Yes, sometimes during our trials and troubles, through our woes, through our losses and devastations and our tragedies, We have to sacrifice a sacrifice of thanksgiving. Thank you, Lord. He tells us in His Word to be thankful for everything. Yes, even the good and the bad that happens. Thank Him that you are still here. Thank Him that He is still God of your life. Thank Him that He is going to carry you through. Thank Him that He is still on the throne. Thank Him that He is still your Redeemer. Thank Him that He bought you with His blood. You are not your own anymore. Psalms 100 said, "The Lord, know ye that the Lord, He is God. It is He that has made us and not we ourselves. We are His people and the sheep of His pasture." Oh, hallelujah. He feeds us with a feast in front of our enemies. He anoints our head with oil and our cup runneth over. Little in the Lord is much. Can we sacrifice a sacrifice of thanksgiving? Hallelujah. And can we declare His works with rejoicing? Oh, wow. Yes, it is a pressing way. It is a hard way sometimes. But when you start praising Him, when you get a song on your heart and you begin to sing unto Him, you begin to tell Him how much you love Him, tell Him how much, hallelujah, you love Him. I love you, Jesus. I love you, Jesus. I love you, Jesus. Oh, that men would praise the Lord for His goodness and His wonderful works to the children of men. Let them exalt Him also in the congregation of the people and praise Him in the assembly of the elders. I hope you're praising God in the chat tonight. Oh, hallelujah, hallelujah. He turns the wilderness into a standing water and dry ground into water springs. How much more has He done? He blesses them also so that they are multiplied greatly and suffers not their cattle to decrease. Again, they are minished and brought low through oppression, affliction, and sorrow. He pours contempt upon princes and causes them to wander in the wilderness where there is no way. He sets the poor on high, away from their affliction. He makes him families like a flock. The righteous see it and rejoice, and all iniquity shall stop her mouth. Whoso is wise and will observe these things, when they shall understand the loving kindness of the Lord. My, my, my. Go with me over into the book of Ephesians, the 5th chapter. Hallelujah. Be ye therefore followers of God, in the first verse, as dear children. Walk in love as Christ has also loved us and has given Himself for us as an offering and a sacrifice to God for a sweet smelling savor. But fornication and all uncleanness and covetousness, let it not be once named among you that become saints. Sometimes we get discouraged and we get weary in well-doing and we want to hang our harps up on the willow tree and we forget to worship, we forget to pray, we forget to read His Word, we forget. And we say, oh, woe is me. And we have to remind ourselves who we are. We're children of God. We're His people. We're the flock of His pasture. He's faithful to provide for His children. He's faithful to hear and answer our prayers. He's faithful. He's sworn to His Word and He cannot lie. He cannot deny His Word. He has to honor His Word. Let no man deceive you with vain words in the 6th verse of the 5th chapter of Ephesians. For because of these things comes the wrath of God upon the children of disobedience. Don't be found amongst the children of disobedience. Those that have come to the saving knowledge of the Lord Jesus Christ and received Him into your heart, and you've asked Him to be Lord of your life. Sometimes we grow away. We start wandering off from the Lord, especially in 2020 and these trying times. But I want to remind you today, shake yourself. Shake off all the weights that so easily beset you. Galatians tells us, who has so easily bewitched you, O foolish Galatians? Have you been walking with the Lord in the Spirit and now find that walking in the flesh is more rewarding than walking in the Spirit? God forbid. Come clean with the Lord. Repent. He's wooing you. He's calling you. He's long-suffering. We read in Psalms 107 how even the wicked, when they call on to the Lord in their distresses, He saves them. He recovers them. Why? Because He's a merciful God. But there'll come a time when He rains out His righteous indignation upon the disobedient because they refuse to turn to God. Even a wicked person, when they turn to the Lord and ask Him for His help, they're acknowledging Him, they're believing in Him, they're asking Him for His mercy. Lord, have mercy on me one more time. Yeah, we make a lot of broken promises, but He's loving, and He's patient, and He's kind, and He's long-suffering. He's more loving than we are. Sometimes our loved ones get on our last nerve. Sometimes our loved ones don't live the way we think they should live. They don't live upright before the Lord. They don't live in a holy manner unto God. They don't separate themselves from the things of this world, and they continue to practice whatever their flesh wants them to do. And we cut them off. We don't want anything to do with them. But I don't want blood on my hands. I've been guilty. I've been so sick and tired of my loved ones that I want to just cut them off sometimes. But because I have the Holy Ghost on the inside of me, He deals with me. He deals with me even in the wee hours of the night when I'm asleep and I dream. And the Lord shows me, forgive them, for they know not what they do. Jesus on the cross was making intercession for you and me on the cross. He said, Father, forgive them, for they know not what they do. They were spitting on Him, laughing at Him. They were blaspheming, and they crucified Him, counting Him as a sinner. He carried all of our sins away on that cross through the shedding of His innocent blood. And He looked down at us as His heart reached up to heaven. And He said, Father, forgive them, for they know not what they do. How can we do this? How can we love our loved ones? How can we love the wicked? When we remember that we haven't always been saved. When we remember, if it weren't for the grace of God calling us to Him and Him blessing us and receiving us unto Himself, we would be as they are. We must not forget mercy, and we must not forget to stand in the gap for our loved ones and for the wicked. He tells us to pray for our enemies and curse them not. Are we doing that? Are we lining up with His word and loving one another? I even get short with one of my brothers and sisters in Christ sometimes, and I have to ask God to forgive me And if I need to go back to my brother and sister, I apologize to them. Sometimes they don't even know I'm upset with them. And then sometimes they know I am upset with them. But God's grace and His mercy, His grace is sufficient for us, and His mercies are new every morning. Let me finish this chapter here. Seventh verse says, "Be not ye therefore partakers with them. For ye were sometimes darkness, but now are ye light in the Lord. Walk as children of light. For the fruit of the Spirit is in all goodness and righteousness and truth, proving what is acceptable unto the Lord. And have no fellowship with the unfruitful works of darkness, but rather reprove them. For it is a shame even to speak of those things that are done of them in secret. Help us. Help us, Lord, to stop gossiping. Help us, Lord, to quit sharing the evidence and the works of the wicked." We on Facebook is the worst place for, I've seen the saints of God and Christians sharing such horrible, ungodly things. And we aren't even to talk about the evil that they're doing. We shouldn't talk about it. We shouldn't give it legs. We shouldn't give it a mouthpiece. We shouldn't even give it power. We should pray over it and pass over it. We have to plead the blood of Jesus, as Christ, as God told us to put the blood on the doorpost as the spirit of death walks over. And if he sees the blood, he'll pass over. We have to pass over these things and not give them power, not give them the day, the time of day. Stop sharing ungodly things and share godly things. Share good things that are uplifting, and stop repeating what they have done. Stop repeating it as children of God. We shouldn't have sweet water and bitter water coming out of our mouth, out of the same fountain. We must remind ourselves of who we are. We're children of God, and we are to exemplify the very fruit of the Spirit, the very Spirit of Christ that we say that we have on the inside of us. But all things that are reproved are made manifest by the light. For whatsoever doth make manifest is light. Wherefore he saith, "Awake thou that sleepeth, and arise from the dead, and Christ shall give thee light. See then that you walk circumspectly, not as fools, but as wise, redeeming the time, because of the days are evil." Yes, they're evil. We're living in the last days. We're living in days of sorrow. These are days of sorrow, but this is not the end. It can get much worse. And I don't want to be here. I want Jesus to take me up out of here. "Wherefore be ye not unwise, but understanding what the will of the Lord is. And be not drunk with wine wherein is excess, but be filled with the Spirit." Let's pray that the Holy Spirit fill us up. As Bishop Kyle used to say, till the Holy Ghost is running out my eyes, my nose, my ears, my mouth. I want him pouring out all over me. Hallelujah. Fill me up, Lord. Fill me up, Lord. Speaking to ourselves in psalms and hymns and spiritual songs, singing and making melody in your heart to the Lord. Giving thanks always for all things unto God and the Father, in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ, submitting yourselves one to another in the fear of God. Wives, submit yourselves unto your own husbands as unto the Lord. And for the husbands, he is the head of the wife. And even as Christ is the head of the church, and he is the Savior of the body, Sometimes there needs to be a round table discussion between husband and wife. Sometimes you can't. So the one that's wise and knowledgeable and knows that things may be out of order in their household, that one needs to get down on their knees and pray and start asking God to put things in order. Because if things are out of order in your home, they're going to be out of order in the church. Your children are not going to be blessed. And the Lord does not have to answer your prayers. There needs to be order set in our homes. Therefore, as the church is subject unto Christ, so let the wives be to their own husbands in everything. Husbands, love your wives, even as Christ also loved the church and gave himself for it. If you have a good man, if you have a good husband, you ought to rejoice. If you have a good wife, man, husbands, if you have a good wife who knows how to set herself by your side and to honor you and respect you and to put you first, you ought to rejoice. If you don't, then you need to get on your knees and stand in the gap and love that woman into submission as unto the Lord. Yes, these are hard words because these are different times that we live in. Women have risen up to where they're awful. Unsubmissive. They're not submissive. They're mouthy. They have attitudes that the Bible says, I'd rather dwell on the rooftop than in the house with a crazy, scowling, scornful woman. Why? Because she can make you most miserable. I didn't come tonight to get on this, but praise God, it is His Word. And when things are out of order, we ought to come together and pray. We ought to both come together in humility and repent to God and ask God to help us. Take one day at a time. It's not going to change overnight because the other disorder didn't happen overnight. It happened over a period of time. And we just need to realize to be careful and to walk softly before the Lord because He's seeing and He's watching. Wow, praise God. Hallelujah. That He might sanctify and cleanse it with the washing of the water by the Word. That He might present it to Himself a glorious church, not having spot or wrinkle or any such thing, but that it should be holy and without blemish. So ought men to love their wives as their own bodies. He that loves his wife loves himself. For no man ever yet hated his own flesh, but nourishes and cherishes it, even as the Lord cherishes and nourishes the church. For we are members of his body, of his flesh, and of his bones. For this cause shall a man leave his father and mother, and shall be joined unto his wife, and they two shall be one flesh. And this is a great mystery, but I speak concerning Christ and the church. Nevertheless, let every one of you in particular so love his wife, even as himself. And the wife see that she reverence her husband. Praise God, praise God, praise God. I want to go back up to the 22nd verse. Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah. Over in Psalms 107 and 22. And let them sacrifice the sacrifices of thanksgiving and declare his works with rejoicing. I pray that I've said something to bless you tonight in the Word. But tonight, If you don't know Jesus as your personal Savior, get to know Him, the one who died on the cross and gave Himself for you, just as the Scripture said that He gave Himself, He laid down His life for you and me. He carried all of our sins to the cross. He was beat on His back with 39 stripes for the healing of all diseases. God Himself is our healer. And by Jesus' stripes, we are healed, soul, mind, and body. Come to Jesus. Come to Jesus while you have a chance, while He's dealing with your heart, as you feel Him knocking on your heart's door. And He said, open up your heart and let me come in, and I will sup with you and you sup with me. He will forgive you of all of your sins. He will wash them away with His precious blood. Invite Him into your heart to be Lord of your life. Give Him a chance. And then take up your cross, which means choose to walk daily with the Lord. Get in His Word and read about His laws, His principles, His commandments, His promises, and the power that's in the name of Jesus. A lot of times we don't know how to pray. Sometimes there's just groaning. The tears will come and they're purging us of things that we don't even know about. But the Holy Ghost knows where they're at. So if you've prayed a prayer tonight of repentance and asked Jesus to come into your heart, and then you start loving Him and telling Him thank you, if you have, you can call that number on the screen. If you have prayed that prayer of salvation and you have asked the Lord Jesus Christ to come into your heart, call that number and leave a message and say, I have been saved tonight. But join us every Sunday morning for Sunday school at 10 o'clock, morning worship at 11, evenings at 7, Tuesday morning prayer and Bible study at 11, and Wednesday night service at 7. We love you. This is Elder Susan Corr. And tonight's message was, let's be thankful. God bless you.